Canon is providing a free firmware upgrade for many Canon EOS and PowerShot camera models and Cinema EOS models. We're giving a general overview of the significant new additions in a separate video, but in the next few minutes, I want to provide some details about one area in particular, the new security features it adds. This firmware is a free download from the support page for your camera model on the Canon USA website and is available now. The changes in security will be added automatically when this firmware is installed in your camera. First off, the security additions are for compliance with international regulations to provide protection for user information that is in the camera, and especially to limit unauthorized access to anything the camera is connected to, from your phone to a network. Please be aware, this is not a theft deterrent feature and is not intended for that purpose. It will not lock the camera so that it cannot be used by an unauthorized person. And it has nothing to do with verifying content authenticity. When you start the camera up after installing this firmware, you will be presented with a screen requiring you to create a 6-digit password or PIN number. You must enter this password or PIN number, which you create, to start the camera. Tap the highlighted box and enter the 6-digit password you want to use. The camera will now require that same password to be entered on screen the next time you start it up, and also if it's recovering from sleep mode. However, there is a checkbox immediately under where you created this password labeled Do Not Ask Again. If you check this box, you won't be asked to enter that password again on subsequent startups. If you do check the box, keep in mind that this means there will now be no password protection to prevent unauthorized access to the camera and any connected devices. And if you need to change your password because you forgot the original one or for any other reason, you can do so in the Manage Password menu area, which we'll discuss in a moment. Again, this is not intended to prevent theft of your camera. With this new firmware installed in your camera, a new menu item will be added to the yellow Setup menu area, Manage Password. Select this and press Set to enter it, and you'll be presented with the following menu choices for this security feature. Password Request. You'll need to re-enter the 6-digit password or PIN number to turn this on or off. Turning it off means you won't be asked for that password on future startups or when the camera is awakened from sleep mode. Change Password. This gives you the ability to change the password you previously entered. You need to enter the existing password first and then create a new one here to change it. Clear Entered Information. If you forget your current password and need to create a new one to start up the camera, you'd use this menu setting. However, this is a complete factory reset of all camera information, including any customization features, your date and time settings, and so on. So it definitely clears the previous password, but also all other camera settings. One question that may come up, if you change your password, you can reuse an earlier one you entered. The camera won't require a unique new user-created password if you do change it. There will be another new menu item in a different area of that same yellow setup menu. This is Show Log Display, which will allow you to view a list of changes to your password, changes or initializing of security-related settings like wireless connections, and a log of any password failures that may have occurred. In other words, it'll let you see if other persons have attempted to manipulate your security settings. To limit the risk of online brute force password attacks, the camera will lock after 10 consecutive failed password attempts and require about a 10-minute wait before re-entering a password. Alternatively, you can turn off the camera's main power switch and back on again to resume attempts to enter your current password. Finally, to be clear, there is no way to upgrade your camera's firmware and not have this security feature installed as well. But to repeat, once you enter a six-digit password once, you can then opt to bypass needing to enter it again if you feel the added security isn't needed. We hope this helps clarify this new security initiative, and we thank you for joining us.